Hello everyone, it's Angela Nesbitt and welcome to My Color Story. Today, I am telling my story. So I hope that everyone will join me in the comments and chime in and tell about your story, but I'm gonna blaze the trail and start first and tell you how I started out and how I found my voice. And hopefully that will inspire you or just give you a gentle nudge in the direction of finding your voice. So just to review, how do we tell our story? It's just about what's inside of us already, and we just need to uncover it and let it unfold and let it grow and nurture it and really kind of put blinders on and not pay attention to, you know, what other people are doing and just really dig deep into what we're about and the story that we want to tell in our art and really just pay attention, do more of what you love and stay in your lane and have a lot of fun with it. So my story began when I was dabbling in art. I really had no direction. I was doing watercolor. I really had no idea what I was doing. I was actually mostly frustrated and not enjoying the process so much until I found Andy Braitman, the amazing, amazing, incredibly talented teacher and mentor and all things art here in Charlotte, North Carolina. And he took me under his wing and he taught me, he encouraged me, and for many, many years. So in the beginning, right when I met him, I actually, very shortly after starting with him, I became pregnant with my daughter. And so when I came back from having my daughter, of course, she very quickly was my muse within at least a year. So all I wanted to do was paint her, which was such a predictable, you know, girl on the beach. You know, everyone was doing that. It was a very crowded space, but I was still learning to paint, to draw, which I wasn't very good at, learning to mix colors. And so that's just, you know, where I kind of started the process. So the process just started out of this passion to learn to paint and to really want to paint my daughter. So in the very beginning, things were very predictable. You know, the very obvious little girl on the beach with the bucket kind of look. And, you know, that's where it started. And I really wanted to do something different, and I knew that. And I also loved exploring the surface of the canvas and creating some a little bit more unpredictable applications and studying light, studying color, the surface, all of it coming together and really just following what I loved. And I was able to come up with something that was different. And it just kind of emerged and unfolded as I followed my passion, really. And these large figures started to come out. And this was my daughter. And I had to be real careful because my son would count how many paintings, once he came along, how many paintings there were of her. So I had to make sure that I equaled that out, particularly when I had shows. He would go around the galleries and count. So here's one of him as well. So my voice started to come out, and my daughter had a ton of energy and she was always moving, and so was my son. And so the kids in motion with a lot more energetic paint application and all of that came together, and it was hours and hours and hours of painting and exploration, painting more than 40 hours a week, not selling anything hardly at the time until finally my signature look came out and people really responded to it. It had emotion. It was different. It was energetic and I was really passionate about it, and that came through to the viewer, which is what you want no matter what you're painting. So this went on for a couple of years and it was a ton of fun, but at some point I got tired, a little bit burned out on only doing figures. So I showed up at Andy's studio one afternoon to paint, and there was a still life set up, and I thought, well, I really had no intention of painting flowers at all. And I thought, but this would be a really nice break today. You know, I'm just gonna kind of cut loose and do a floral. And it was really fun because it was all about exploring that surface and playing with the paint. And I could really loosen up and I didn't have to worry so much about something looking human or looking, you know, looking like a person. And it was very liberating. So it was just kind of a fluke. This whole other avenue in my art opened up, and people really, really responded to that as well. Again, it was the passion, and it was the chaotic paint application and having fun with it and following what I really was enjoying doing. So I just sort of followed the path, and then from there other subject matter and things have evolved, and my work has certainly evolved and continues to. But the point here is to really get excited about something and to stick with it. I thought, you know, I'm sticking with something that's really predictable and it's a really crowded market, but I knew I wanted to do it. And I knew that I wanted to find a way to do it my way, and it worked. So really just sticking with that passion, showing up to the easel every day or as many days as possible with excitement and energy and learning and experimenting and exploring all of those things. And all of those things I still do today. If I don't do those things, then I get pretty bored with my work. So just continue to do those things. And if you're just starting out, just really follow your gut and follow what you love and have fun with it and tell your story. Your story can be sweet and flowery, or it can be aggressive and angry. It can be anything. It can be whatever you want it to be, but it needs to be your story. So I hope this helps, and I really hope that everyone will jump in the comments and share your story. If you're just starting out, that's awesome. If you're way down your road and you're just trying to shake things up a little bit, that's great too. But jump in the comments and start a conversation. Also, you can jump over to Angela's Color Story on Facebook, my free group. And there's tons of fun conversation going on over there. And I hope that they'll ignite a conversation on this over there as well. If you missed all the beginning of Unleashing Your Artistic Voice, that's on my website in the blog section, angelanesbitt.com. The first one starts with Unleashing Your Voice, and then they go in sequential order. So you can grab those. There's also an accompanying PDF that goes with it. So I hope you all are happy painting and jumping in the comments and telling us all about your journey. Okay, have a great day.